Hello, everyone. Welcome to Sabbath Services on this chilly day. In John 14:15, Jesus tells us, "If you love me, you'll keep my commandments." And as I was reading through the Bible, I figured that it would be good to talk about the 11th commandment. Does anybody know what the 11th commandment is? No, huh? Okay, if we turn to John 13, in 34 and 35, having trouble getting to it. I'm not nervous, but it says, "A new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you. So you must love one another. By this everyone will know you are my disciples if you love one another." So I considered that the 11th commandment, because he said it was a new commandment he's given us. All right. Now, as a while ago, Mr. Thomas gave me the okay to make the prayer list, and I have extras for anyone that hasn't gotten one yet. I would like to tell you how it started. I walked around with a yellow pad of paper and came up to everyone that I could and asked them if they needed it on the prayer list. And I was pretty excited, and the first one came out, and time went by, and I said, "Well, it's time to update." And as I was preparing to update, walking around, my arthritis was a lot worse, and it was very hard for me to come up to everyone and ask them if they needed help. So I would sit in the vestibule, and as people came in, I would try to contact them and see if they needed on the list. And one day, God sent a blessing to me and to everyone else. A woman came in, and she was serving God, and she set the church telephone directory on the table out there, and Mrs. Thomas gave me one. And I says, "Oh, this is how I can update the prayer list without beating myself to death." So I'm going to ask you that once you have this, if you turn to Revelation, well, you don't have to turn there, I can just tell you. Revelation 5:8 says, "The angel has golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints." Now, our prayers are incense to God. And in, if you look in Proverbs 15:8, it just says, "The prayer of the upright please him." Now, is there anybody out there that does not want to please God? Okay, so now I know that you're all going to pray the prayer list, right? So, as the said in Revelation, that the prayers go up to God and the angel offers them on the golden bowls. Anyway, if God created us and we are all unique, that means that we all, possibly means, I can't say for sure, but it that we would all have a different fragrance, a different incense going up to God. Now, as the angel gathers these, as we pray throughout the day, at different times whenever we do. There's so many different frankincense, myrrh, coriander, sweet paprika, star anise, turmeric, nutmeg. Each one of us has our own unique flavor incense. And as the angel gathers these, and then he raises them up to God, and God and Jesus are sitting on the throne, and they go, "Oh, that's the Cleveland church, and it smells so good." But yes, he said it does, and it's pleasing to him, so it's good that we do this. And it goes up, and but then they sit there. Do they sit there and say, "Wow, out of 50 people, I only smell 42 incenses. Where are these other 8 or so people at?" Well, we're pleased by this, and we will answer some of the prayers, and possibly if more people prayed for the prayer list, God might smile down upon us and give us his blessings. As I contact everyone and write down the just basic general needs, as we go throughout the week, if we contact each other that are on the list and say, "Hi, how you doing? Are you better? Are you worse? What's happening? Can we?" I ad lib a little after I find out more from what I'm talking to everyone. And one of the people that had a friend on the list who just died a week ago, my ad-libbing was that this person would be healed of their liver cancer, and knowing that it came through the prayers of this congregation, they would be interested and drawn to God, and that he could use this to call them to come to Sabbath services. And I thought, you know, ad-lib this, it's not on the list, but to pray that this person would, because she had told me he was interested in being a Christian, but then he kind of fell off, and then recently he smashed his head and died. But as you look at the list, the first one on the list is Tom Sanda, who's a friend of my brother's and myself. He has his cancer, and he's dying. He turned yellow, and I pray the same prayer for him, that he would be healed. He would know that it was because we're praying for him that he would be attracted to come to church and Sabbath services. So if you can contact each other, talk to each other and say, "Hey, how you doing?" Maybe that they can give you a little bit more that they need. Or, you know, you can ad lib like I do. So it says, now, here's a prayer that I started praying for everyone. I was reading, and I came across the number 666. So I says, "Well, this is pretty interesting. I wonder if God will allow me to partake of this." And I started praying about it. And then I thought, "Glenn, you're being pretty selfish. I should pray for all the people in this church for this 666. What a tremendous blessing this is going to be for us. Is there anybody that doesn't want me to pray that they receive the blessing of the 666? Everybody wants that blessing, huh? All right. And if you turn to 2 Chronicles, number 9, Second Chronicles 9 and verse, I'm going to get to it before I tell you. In verse 13, and it says, "The weight of the gold that Solomon received yearly was 666 talents." Now, I don't know how much a talent weighs, but I have to believe 666 talents is a lot of weight of gold. So I've been praying that we can share in this 666. Not the one at the back of the Bible, but the one here in the front. So they're in my prayers that God will allow us to all partake of this. And I'm going to ask you again, is there anyone here that does not want to please God? Oh, so you all do. So I ask you to daily pray the prayer list for the brothers and sisters.